Alright boys, today we are going over the stage 4 affinities and how to finish them super fast. Now, not only is this a guide on how to finish it fast, but it's also a guide on how to prepare for it. So I know a bunch of you guys are wondering how to prepare for stage 4, where is stage 4, when is it coming? And in my opinion, it's going to come in the first or second week of November. I definitely just see that happening. Now, before we get into this video, if you guys hit that like button, hit that sub button, I would really appreciate it. We're growing every single day and every sub helps. And honestly, that game last night, I hope you guys were watching it. The Rays and Dodgers game was insane. A walk-off was crazy. I can't believe that the catcher just absolutely let it go behind him. Yes, the error was bad, but it could have been avoided. But wow, what an ending to an amazing game. Now the Rays have momentum, and they're kind of putting on the Dodgers. I'm super excited to see what's going to happen. I really hope that Rosarena keeps on popping off. This dude is just an absolute animal. So anyways, guys, let's get right into this video on how to prepare for Stage 4 affinities. Today we are going to be going over stage 4 affinities and how to prepare for them. Now this is a video I want to do because I feel like stage 4 is literally around the corner. I put my predictions video out already and I kind of just went over some things, but I definitely think that it's going to come soon. I could see finals coming out literally as soon as the World Series ends, or literally a week after, maybe around there. I think it'll be in November. I think there's no chance that we don't get finals in November, so it'll definitely happen sometime around there. Maybe they'll drop it a little bit before Thanksgiving and stuff like that, but I consider these coming out very soon, and I wanted to get out a tips and tricks video on how to prepare for stage 4 affinity and as well as how to complete stage 4 affinity whenever it comes out. So I'm going to go over some of these things, and I'm going to go over just kind of some of the affinities. I know that I don't have all of them done, but I have a good amount of these done, and I have a lot of tips that you guys are going to want to capitalize on now, because there's a lot of things that you can do now that are going to be huge, because whenever these exchange cards go way up in price, then it's going to be really expensive whenever stage 4 comes out. This is also an investments video, so if you want to invest in some of these cards that I start talking about in the video that are pretty much cheaper right now, but they could go really expensive soon, I would highly suggest it. Alright, so first off, whenever you look at some of these teams, you got to keep in mind the finest cards that they have on their team, and that the cards and the team affinities are actually going to be worth it. For example, the Orioles probably aren't going to be worth it, and I don't really consider maybe like someone like the Mariners being really either, or the Rangers. Maybe a Lance Lynn gets a card, or Joey Gallo gets a card, they just hand him one. But I don't really see these cards being good, so I wouldn't recommend grinding their affinities. I would recommend grinding the affinities of cards that are going to be really good. In my opinion, the Dodgers are going to be really good. I believe that the Padres are going to be pretty good. I believe Manny Machado is going to get an insane card. And I also think the Phillies will be good, because I believe they're going to give Real Muto a card and stuff like that. Maybe the Rays and the Yankees. The Yankees haven't really gotten a good card since 88 Glaber, and so I could really see them doing something good here. Obviously, Don Mattingly wasn't what a lot of people wanted. So I recommend doing the affinities that you think are going to be good. I've already done the Yankees affinity. I've already done the Dodgers affinity. And I'm going to start working on the Padres affinity. And as well as I'm honestly thinking about doing someone like the Angels affinity. I just a weird hunch that they're going to go something weird here. Give Rendon a good card or something like that. And so I kind of want to do that. The Cubs could also have some good cards. Trevor Bauer might be in the Reds. So be careful about some of these cards, and even like someone like the Brewers, I believe Hader might get it again, you never know. And so just basically you just want to be doing the affinities for the cards that you think are going to get good stage 4 cards, are going to get finest cards. Teams that pitched really good this year, did really good this year, played really good this year, or guys that were absolute animals, I would recommend doing them too. Just necessarily do this. So how you're going to be getting these done and how you're going to be doing this fast. Obviously, the first one that I'm going to go over is you're going to want to be doing your showdowns. Now, showdowns can be a little bit hard, but they get easier as you go. I know that these firsts are kind of a pain in the butt, the stage ones, but they have made them a little bit easier. As I've done these a lot, I've done a lot of showdowns, and I might make a tips and tricks video. Let me know down in the comment section below if you guys want a tips and tricks video on how to complete showdowns. Because I know they're pretty annoying, but if you can just crank out like one or two of these a day, then you're going to be helping your team affinities a lot. That way you don't have to buy all of these cards, and even if you want to, you can make tons of stubs off these. Stage 3 team affinities were sellable, and I 100% believe that stage 4 affinities are going to be the same way. So I highly recommend doing this, because it's going to make you tons of stubs, absolute tons of stubs. Now, another thing that you can do is whenever you're doing these showdowns, you can do these stuff. one of the big things that I'm going to be talking about today is going to be how to do exchanges efficiently. Now, you're not always going to want to do this, but you have to be very smart about your exchanges. You don't want to be wasting tons of stubs. So for someone like the Yankees, I've already done the Yankees, but that's I consider them getting a really good card. So Yankees rivals. Now, not you could exchange all of your little small cards. Like, I've been kind of stacking up on small cards. I have tons of these guys for exchanges. I've just been holding on to them, not really selling them. So if you guys are like me and you have tons of these guys, you can definitely use these guys and get rid of them. You can also use them in the exchange sets to get silvers and golds that are sellable. I recommend definitely doing the gold sellable ones because those 1,000 stubs really add up. And basically, some of these guys you're just going to want to go after. Now, basically, the cards that you want to go after are the cards that are really, really cheap. And you don't want to go over the ones that are more expensive and kind of just weird. In my opinion, you don't want to go over, like, especially like Keith Foulke. He's going to be expensive because he's one of the postseason cards. So don't buy this card. Brendan McKay is going to be expensive. But you can look at some of these cards that are like 5,000, 6,000 quick sell value. Chris Sale should be around 6K. Yeah, Chris Sale's around 6K. And that's pretty much a full exchange there. So that's 6K for pretty much 10 points. You can add this guy with a bunch of your guys that you have in your exchanges. So this is what I'm going to be doing. I think Nick Anderson is not really worth it because he's going to be worth a little bit more. Yeah, 5,500, but he's not the exchange value that you necessarily want. Another thing, some of these golds can be really good, especially you guys like you can get like 4 Teoscar Hernandezes. I don't recommend Blake Snell, obviously, because a lot of people are thinking he's going to go diamond. And I honestly personally think that he is going to go diamond. If you guys aren't investing in this card, I think you're baked. Blake Snell has absolutely pitched the crap out of the baseball in the postseason. He literally needs one more, so invest in this card, please. It'll make you a ton of stubs. Anyways, on a sidetrack, let's get back to what we were talking about. Cards like Charlie Morton, these postseason cards, I'd stay away from a little bit. Although Charlie Morton's a little bit better and only worth 1,500 stubs, they could be skyrocketing, and so you don't really want to work on that too. Jonathan Scope's going to be expensive because he's a breakout card, and some of these rookie cards are even expensive too, but not all of them. I mean, like 18K for Tom Seaver. So just be smart about it. That's what I'm talking about. You want to make sure, do your calculations, make sure that these guys aren't way too expensive. You're not wasting a ton of stubs. I don't want you guys to be like, man, I don't really know what to do. And then you guys end up paying way too many stubs whenever you literally wasted a ton of stubs to get these cards. I really recommend doing some of these exchanges or even holding on to them. Like, I'm going to be doing this for the Yankees. I'm going to be buying a couple of cards now before they do this. Another big thing that you guys can do for these affinities to finish them fast, to get them done quick before you can get to stage 4, is basically with all of these New York Yankees players, stuff like that, you can play innings with them. Now, these don't have to be online. You can literally stick 9 of them on your team, and you can just go to work. And the thing is they're repeatable, and you can literally play like 2 9-inning games, kind of just chill and watch Netflix, and you can be grinding your affinities because you're literally just putting innings in. I mean, just put it on rookie difficulty and just let the game go on for a little bit, and you'll be surprised how many team affinity points you get. This is something that's really mindless and easy to do. I do this while watching Netflix sometimes and stuff like that. That's how I do the Yankees. And it's a little bit easier than Showdown. I know that Showdown can be a little hard. Another big stage is whenever you're going from like stage 2 to stage 3, if you need like 9 more, make sure that you don't forget about the moments. And my last thing is don't do the March to October. I did one of these once. It is not worth it. They take way long. I did one and it literally took me like 8 hours of game time. It took so long. It was fun. I'm going to be honest. I had a blast doing it. I like to do a couple of those every single year, but I don't recommend doing those. They take forever, and they will honestly waste your guys' time. I don't want your guys' time to be wasted doing this stuff. Obviously, there's a ton of stuff going on. If you guys want to make stubs, check out my stub method. But another just quick little thing is to build your stub count up to be able to do the exchanges. One thing that I recommend is just selling those postseason players. I know a lot of you guys need them for your team, and if you do, then that takes priority. Don't take my advice. If you need them for your team, take your team. But if you don't need those postseason cards, like in my opinion, I don't think the postseason cards are going to be that good. That Giancarlo Stanton literally looks like 97 Stanton side by side. It's crazy how close they look alike. And so basically, just if you sell those cards, you're literally going to make about 300K, and you're going to have stubs in the top right. Like, I've had stubs to spare a ton. I bought Honus Wagner. This dude's done absolutely amazing. If you were on stream yesterday, you know that dude was cracked. In his debut, he literally went 3-for-5, and the dude's just an absolute animal. He's hitting 600. I love this card. But I have all of these stubs in plus because of all of the Championship Series cards. You can literally just make stubs by doing this, by literally just going, not the monthly rewards, But you can go to your collections, you can do the World Series stuff, and you can sell these postseason cards. They're all selling for tons. Even these guys are selling for like 13K. I recommend doing it. A lot of people are if they're not using them in your squad. Like, I'm using Julio Urias, so he's not going to get out of my squad, obviously. But if I wasn't using him, I would sell him for probably about the 30K, 15K that he's worth. And I think that's a really smart idea to do these. You also get those exchange players and those extra like player packs from not only playing the events by doing the World Series program, so I recommend that as well. Guys, I appreciate you for watching. Stay into the end. I really appreciate it. We have a viewer league going on from 7 to 9 tonight whenever this video is posted. It's happening on Sunday. It's going to happen 7 to 9. It's going to be on stream. I'm going to be streaming it. We're going to be having a good time. If you guys want to be in the next viewer league, then you're going to have to be in my live streams, which are Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, and Sunday. Now, my schedule and everything going on with that is on my Instagram link in the description. So if you want to stay up to date with me, you want to be in viewer leagues, you want to play with me and hang out with me and my chat, then come out there. My streams are a lot of fun. We have a blast over there, so make sure you're checking that. Make sure you're following my Instagram because you're going to get the latest content. Again, guys, if you're not subbed, I'm looking at you. Hit that like button, hit that sub button. I'll see you guys in the next video, and thank you for watching.